Hey everyone, I'm Don't Tread On Me Game Reviews, and today I'll be reviewing Terminator Resistance for the PlayStation 4. The game was made by Teyon, infamous for creating bad on-rail shooters like Rambo the Video Game and the Shattered Spear series. So how does Terminator Resistance compare? As you start up the game, you're greeted with a title screen with a picture of the T-800 Terminator staring at you. When you start a new game, you're greeted with four difficult settings: easy, normal, hard, and extreme. Make sure you pick extreme. Terminator Resistance, let's just say, is not a very difficult game. I finished the game last week over the weekend. It's also a pretty easy platinum as well. Set after the events of Judgment Day, Terminator Resistance finds you playing as Jacob Rivers, a member of the Resistance. Having just escaped potential death from the claws of a T-800 Terminator, Rivers finds himself alone and defenseless. He receives an incoming transmission from someone unknown to him, telling him to go to the evacuation point. As Rivers' story progresses, he will encounter various survivors along his journey. He must protect and help them while also making contact with the Resistance, helping them with their fight against the machines. Overall, the story is pretty solid, though some of the side quests which you do on behalf of the survivors can be tedious and boring. Gameplay in Terminator Resistance can be a mixed bag. At times, Terminator Resistance can feel somewhat okay, and at other times, generic and boring. But despite this, there are parts in the game that are completely brilliant and show the signs of being truly a great game. These moments include when you're sneaking around the T-800s at the hospital, where you will be searching for captive Resistance fighters, or when you're fighting alongside fellow Resistance fighters during the more linear levels. To me, these moments were the best part of the game. Its authentic lore is faithful to the first two beloved Terminator movies, that makes all Terminator sequels after Judgment Day put to shame. The enemy AI can also be a bit of a mixed bag. During the open levels, they can behave quite mindless, lacking any real signs of being threatening and intelligent killing machines. This is particularly true when you face off with the T-800s. The level of coordination is poor and they seem to be lacking in proper situation awareness. However, this somewhat changes during the more linear levels, when they are working together with other machines. They seem more coordinated and competent during these sections of the game. Terminator Resistance mission objectives are divided into two parts, main quests and side quests. The main quests will usually involve a combination of fetch quests, retrieving certain people for the Resistance, and taking pictures for reconnaissance missions. During the more linear levels, Rivers, together with fellow Resistance fighters, will lead an assault on various Skynet installations and bases. Side quests will usually involve mainly fetch quests for various NPC characters that you will be encountering in Terminator Resistance. These side quests are mostly repetitive and boring. I found the best side quest was the one where you have to find a puppy for Patrick. On top of that, there are also side quests which you encounter when exploring the streets of Pasadena. These usually involve having to infiltrate and destroy Terminator outposts by either destroying Skynet energy containers or by hacking the computer mainframe. During your journey, you'll be able to acquire lots of resources by looting the various locations where loot can be found. Here's one of the biggest flaws in Terminator Resistance gameplay. You can acquire so much loot that rarely will you have to use the game crafting mechanics or have to buy anything from the quartermasters at the shelter. It also is one of the most fundamental reasons why the game is fairly easy. I didn't die once until I reached the streets of Pasadena. There are so many medikits to be found, you literally will never run out during your playthrough. Other game mechanics include lockpicking and hacking. Lockpicking can be used to open doors, boxes of loot, boots of cars, and ambulance bays. Though you have various difficult settings, I notice you will not encounter any of the hard lockpicking difficulty until towards closer to the end of the game. There are so many things to lockpick, it becomes tedious, and the loot you receive is usually the standard ammo, rags, bottles, leftover materials, pipe bombs, medikits, and other items. You'll also be able to find a device in which you'll be able to use to hack various turrets, locked mechanized doors, computer mainframes, and metal boxes. When hacking, the device pops open. You are then presented with a Frogger-like minigame. You must get your little circle from point A to point B to complete the process. You'll be required to do a lot of hacking in the game. This too becomes tedious. The weapons in the game feels great and make excellent blast sounds. During the third level, you'll begin to acquire laser weapons in order to combat the T-800s. Regular weapons are ineffective on them. This is where another problem begins to arise in Terminator Resistance. Once you receive these weapons, there really is no need to avoid or sneak past the T-800s. Worse yet, they can be easily killed, and their atrocious enemy AI just adds to that ease. The T-800s do become more difficult once they are equipped with Skynet's second-generation laser rifles, but once you acquire these weapons, the T-800s become even more easier to kill. I would have liked it more of a challenge when encountering them, though shooting them and watching them blow up is pretty satisfying. Terminator Resistance does contain a leveling system where you'll be able to gain experience points by completing quests, lockpicking, hacking, and destroying various machines in Terminators. You can then gain skill points every time you level up your character. You can then use these skill points to improve your skill sets in three categories: combat, science, and survival. In the combat category, you can upgrade your stealth skills, which will decrease your visibility and presence radius. The weapon skill set will make your various weapons more powerful, and the explosive skill set will increase the damage when using explosives. Over to the science category, you can upgrade your lockpicking, hacking, and crafting skills. Every level up for the lockpicking and hacking skill will increase your ability to lockpick or hack at a greater difficulty. Upgrading your crafting skills will increase the number of different items which you will be able to craft. And finally, we have the survival category. Here you will be able to upgrade your backpack toughness and fast learning abilities. Every time you upgrade your backpack, an extra row of space will appear in your inventory. Increasing your toughness will make you absorb more damage, and fast learning will increase your ability to operate various laser weapon types. Terminator Resistance visuals, sound, and music is where the game begins to truly shine in its presentation. Terminator Resistance graphics do look a few years dated, but they are overall pretty good. The level of authentic design and look of the game is very well done. Much praise is needed for the amount of fan service placed in the game. These include the ability to name a dog, which you will be able to find as either Max or Wolfie. You will also be able to visit the Resistance shelter, you know, the same one like in the first Terminator movie, with the two dogs and the armed guards at the metal door. And you'll encounter the infamous and deadly T-800 infiltrator. Combine this with the iconic laser weapon sounds and the iconic theme reinvented with electronic guitar, the level of nostalgia reaches a climax during the final assault on Skynet. Terminator Resistance does have some occasional bugs and strange visual anomalies, but I'm sure that these will be patched in a future update, hopefully. Terminator Resistance proves to be a fairly decent game with some game design issues, including poor AI for the T-800s, annoying and tedious lockpicking and hacking mechanics, but overall I found it to be pretty decent in gameplay with a solid story and phenomenal in presentation. It's slightly outdated graphics, in no way does it hinder the game's look or presentation. Terminator Resistance is a must for diehard Terminator fans and diehard FPS fans who love lots of explosions and excellent gunplay. Terminator Resistance gets a 6.5 out of 10. If you liked this review, please like this video and please subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you would like to make a donation in order to keep this channel going, please donate to the following PayPal address you see on screen.